Yo, what's going on? Mike from Mike Talk Sports. The Lakers just picked up game one at Memphis against the Grizzlies. Huge win for the Lake Show. And the story of the game really was Rui Hachimura, Austin Reeves, and these role players playing absolutely incredible alongside LeBron James and Anthony Davis. I feel as though now is the perfect time to address the elephant in the room when it comes to the Lakers role players, Darvin Ham, and his weird obsession with Troy Brown Jr. Yes, in my opinion, I believe Troy Brown Jr. needs to be benched by Darvin Ham, and I believe now is the time to do so. All season long, Darvin Ham has had some questionable rotational decisions, and by far the most peculiar decision game in and game out by Darvin Ham is his weird obsession with playing Troy Brown Jr. significant minutes. So this year for the Lakers, Troy Brown Jr. appeared in 76 games, and he started 46 games for the Lakers this season. Yes, he started over half of the games for the Lakers this season. I completely understand guys like LeBron James and Anthony Davis dealt with injuries throughout the entire season, which causes some bench players to slot into the starting lineup. But there was a lot of times this season, 5-10 game stretches, where every single Laker would be healthy, yet Troy Brown Jr. would still crack the starting lineup. He has 24 minutes a game this season, 43% from the field, 38% from three, 7.1 points per game. Now, Troy Brown Jr., and the main reason he is out there is because of his spacing, because he is an above average three-point shooter, and because of his defense, he has really good 1-3 switchability, and he plays solid defense on wings. But the issue with Troy Brown Jr. really is his offensive game. When his shot isn't going, he's an absolute negative on the court. He is not a good on-ball player at all. So again, if his catch-and-shoot shots are not falling, then teams are going to simply sag off of Troy Brown Jr., dare him to shoot, and dare Troy Brown Jr. to make him beat the other team. And where Troy Brown Jr. really messes up the Lakers offense, again, when his shot isn't going okay, that's one thing. But the thing is, he really lacks that off-ball IQ and that off-ball movement. Troy Brown Jr. genuinely has really bad off-ball movement and just kind of stands at the same exact spot on the court every single time the Lakers are on offense, which really causes the rotations for the defense to be significantly easier. Troy Brown Jr. has some stretches where he's extremely hot and shooting the ball really well. And in stretches like that, I do think Troy Brown Jr. should get about 15 to 17 minutes a game. In this first game against the Grizzlies, he had 17 minutes, 3 points on 1-of-4 shooting, so not great. But that's not even really the issue. It's the last 10 games from Troy Brown Jr. He's really, really struggled from three, and he struggled in general, having career lows in this 10-game stretch. Of course, it's a very small sample size, but in the playoffs, you need to ride the hot hand, and Troy Brown Jr. does not have the hot hand. He is slotted to get about 20 minutes a game in this playoff run for the Lakers. Who else should get these minutes if I'm advocating for Troy Brown Jr. to outright get benched with some DNPs in there, which I do think that should happen unless another role player is really struggling and you do need to bring in a fresh face like Troy Brown Jr. Who should play and who should replace those minutes? Well, right now, at the moment, the Lakers playoff lineup has 9 guys in it, including Troy Brown Jr. So realistically, you can just go to an 8-man rotation and increase some of the minutes of some of your other role players. Guys like Malik Beasley only getting 10 minutes a night in this playoff rotation, when in reality, he's a significantly better and more consistent shooter than Troy Brown Jr. is. Jared Vanderbilt's getting 23 minutes. You could slightly increase his minutes as well because of his defensive presence. Austin Reeves, 31 minutes. I think at this point, Austin Reeves has proved to be a 35, 36 minute per night guy. Rui Hachimura with 30 minutes in that victory. To me, that's a perfect number for Rui Hachimura, or even less minutes. So I wouldn't say to increase his minutes per se. Dennis Schroeder with 20 minutes, I think is pretty good too. LeBron James only played 34 minutes, but I do like LeBron getting less minutes as his career progresses, especially early on in this playoff run, if you do want to make a deep playoff run. But to me, this is not the solution to increase the minutes of the other guys. To me, the solution to this weird Darvin Ham obsession with playing Troy Brown Jr. is very simple. Bench Troy Brown Jr. and give Lonnie Walker Jr. some minutes. I completely do not understand why in the latter part of the season, Lonnie Walker Jr., game in and game out is getting DNPs. He would not have played in this Lakers game if it wasn't a blowout. He only got 1 minute in this game, and make no mistake about it, if it is a close playoff game, Lonnie Walker Jr. is going to get a DNP by Darvin Ham, which makes absolutely no sense. In 56 games for the Lakers this year, he has 32 starts. He shoots 45% from the field, which is better than Troy Brown Jr. He is a significantly better player on the ball and creating his own shot. He's really good from two-point land, shooting above 52% from the two-point arc this season. He's really good around the rim. He shoots 36.5% from three on a bigger sample size than Troy Brown Jr. So in my opinion, it's about a push when you talk about these guys facing off each other in a three-point contest. Maybe Troy Brown Jr. slightly better, but the difference is negligible. And Lonnie Walker Jr. averages 12 points per game when he gets onto the court. He's a great rim runner, a great dunker, and Troy Brown Jr. is a really good dunker as well. He just really lacks that fluidity in the open court, and more specifically in the half court. Troy Brown Jr. could give you some nice looks in the full court offense on a fast break, but Lonnie Walker has the explosiveness and that potential with on the ball creation when nothing is going for your team. Troy Brown Jr. is just going to be standing in the corner, whereas Lonnie Walker Jr. is going to get the ball in his hands and he's going to try to make something happen. And guess what? If you have guys like Austin Reeves, Rui Hachimura, LeBron James, Anthony Davis really get going, Lonnie Walker Jr. is still a dribble drive penetration threat. Not only that, but again, he can give you some solid offensive production from the three. He's a very good defender. I think, in my opinion, he's better at guarding ones and twos than Troy Brown Jr. Troy Brown Jr. is going to guard small forwards and power forwards better than Lonnie Walker Jr. Lonnie Walker is too small for that. But again, if you need a guy to guard a point guard and a shooting guard, Lonnie Walker Jr. is your guy. So in my opinion, I am a big advocate for Lonnie Walker Jr. over Troy Brown. Darvin Ham, what is with your weird obsession with Troy Brown Jr.? Lakers fans or just other NBA fans that watch the Lakers this season, do you guys agree with me? Do you guys disagree with me? What are your thoughts on Troy Brown Jr., Darvin Ham, Lonnie Walker Jr. in this entire Lakers rotation? Let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for listening, guys.